Risk of VTE in fourth-generation OCPs. Combined oral contraceptives, COCs, are oral contraceptive pills composed of a combination of progesterone and estrogen. Some side effects include venous thromboembolism and cerebral venous thrombosis, myocardial infarctions, ischemic stroke, hyperkalemia, weight gain, libido, changes in sexual arousal or satisfaction, depression, acne, leukorrhea, and nostalgia. Each patient is different and hence carries different risk factors for the adverse effects of COCs. There are four generations of COCs. What largely characterizes the different generations of drugs is the molecule used as the progestin component. It was thought that by changing the biochemical structure, rather than the dosage of the progestogen component in the COC, side effects could be decreased. Fourth generation COCs were introduced into the North American market in the year 2000. These were characterized by the addition of the progestin drospirenone. It was initially believed that fourth generation COCs were associated with a lower risk of thrombosis. Additionally, it is currently the only OCP with three indications, namely contraception, premenstrual dysphoric disorder, and moderate acne. Drospirenone is a derivative of 17-alpha spironolactone. It has similar pharmacological actions as progesterone, but no estrogenic or glucocorticoid activities. Its anti-mineralocorticoid activity counteracts the effects of estrogen on liver angiotensin synthesis, hence decreasing the side effects of water and salt retention. Its anti-androgenic activities make it suitable for the treatment of acne. Fourth-generation COCs include Yazmin, Yazminel, and YAZ. The risk of VTE and pulmonary embolism with the use of COCs has been well established. In recent years, concerns have been raised as to whether the risk of VTE is higher in fourth-generation COCs relative to other commonly used COCs. A few studies have been done to assess the risk of VTE associated with fourth-generation COCs. The results are mixed. However, most of them showed an increased risk of VTE with drospirenone-containing COCs compared to previous generations. A study done by the FDA in 2011 looked into the use of combined hormonal contraceptives and the risk of cardiovascular disease. This was a retrospective cohort study, looking at data from four major health centers in the USA. The study endpoint was VTE, which included hospitalized DVT, hospitalized pulmonary embolism, and DVT diagnosed as an outpatient. In the study, drospirenone-containing COCs were compared to comparator COCs as a group, and to LNG2 alone. LNG2 was chosen as a single comparator because it contains the same dose of ethanol estradiol, which has been considered the cause for increased risk of VTE in combined hormonal contraceptives. Results showed that the incidence rate ratio was significantly higher for DRSP relative to the use of combined comparators and LNG2 alone in all users. Compared to group comparators, the risk of VTE and DRSP was 1.74 in all users and 1.77 for new users. Compared to LNG2, the risk of VTE and DRSP was 1.45 in all users and 1.57 in new users. Therefore, the main findings were that all use of the DRSP pill had increased risk of VTE relative to standard low-dose OCPs. There was also an increased risk of VTE in new users of the DRSP pill. Similar findings were found when compared with LNG2. They also found that there was a higher risk of VTE in younger relative to older women in current DSRP users. A possible explanation for this is that older users, even if defined as new users in the study, are less likely to be naive users of COCs or other hormone preparations. How does the current evidence for fourth generation COCs affect clinical practice? This graph shows the likelihood of developing a blood clot in different groups of patients. It shows that in spite of the increased risk of VTE in users of COCs, the risk of VTE is still higher in pregnant and postpartum women. The ACOG and WHO guidelines recommend that patients' risks be assessed before deciding on COC use. In summary, based on studies conducted thus far, there seems to be an increased risk of VTE associated with drospirenone COCs compared to previous generations. Current guidelines recommend the continued use of drospirenone-containing COCs if patient is tolerating the regimen.